I'm not
Well,
quoting him. They are from
I
the
don't know.
works. They are from the works. Kanchan knows
So,
that.
well, I mean, let Suhasini Ali speak. I will just leave.
Go on, Kanchan.
Yeah, so I don't want to get into this Tutu Meme match with Suhasini Ali.
I'm not Suhasini. Once a minute, I'm Subhashini Ali, not Suhasini Ali. I was named
I
after
don't want
Subhash
to
Chandra
get
Bose.
into
That's
I
all right.
don't want to get into a Tutu Meme match with Subhashini Ali
Quite right.
or with anybody else. I will just make a couple of points. This whole idea that the BJP is appropriating Subhash Chandra Bose or his legacy, it's an absurd suggestion. What the BJP or what the Prime Minister Narendra Modi is intent on doing is the restitution of national heroes who were denied their rightful place by the Congress in collaboration with the left and other political parties in the country. It is very easy to say that, oh, the Prime Minister didn't do this, Prime Minister didn't do that. But whatever the Prime Minister has done in terms of restituting Subhash Chandra Bose's legacy, none of the political parties in the country have ever done even a fraction of that. Whether it is releasing the Netaji files in the public domain or subsequently taking up his 125th anniversary to be celebrated with such pomp and grandeur. Let me also remind everybody over here that Subhash Chandra Bose began his political journey as a Congress worker, as a Congress leader, and finally as a Congress president. And on his birth anniversary, the Congress, or what remains of the Congress, did not even bother to make a public mention of it, or the left parties. So I don't want to get into lectures of what is right and what is wrong. So number one, it was not an appropriation or not an attempt to appropriate Subhash Chandra Bose. It is restituting Subhash Chandra Bose's legacy, giving back to him his rightful place in the pantheon of national heroes, and that has been done, and that process will now continue.
Okay,
Number
Subhashni
two,
Ali.
the point
Okay.
the number two, the point which you made, Rahul, about West Bengal and the Ramayan tradition and Jai Sri Ram. Well, let me disappoint people over here by saying that West Bengal has historically had a very strong Ramayan tradition. You mentioned Durga Mata Ki Jai and the Durga tradition. The Durga tradition in West Bengal is culturally and religiously linked to the Ramayan tradition. It is linked to Rama's invocation of the goddess in autumn. So, and I could go on and on and
Okay,
on.
so I'll
I
come
could
back to
tell
you,
you
but I
about
want
Plato's
Subhashni Ali
writings
to
on
respond to
Ramayan.
what you're saying, because you made an important point. Kanchan Gupta made an important point
I
that
could
Prime
also tell you
Minister
about
Modi and the BJP
one
are
of the
not trying
most
to
famous
appropriate the
translation,
legacy
that is
of
the
Subhash
Srinivasa
Chandra
Ramayana.
Bose or to make it seem that he's one of our own, that he was part of the Hindu Mahasabha. They're not saying it. They're saying, of course, he stood for what he did. We're only trying to ensure that we can restore him to the pantheon of great Indian leaders because a disproportionate amount of time is being spent celebrating the
I have
life
a
of Pandit
point.
Jawaharlal Nehru rather than the entire flanks of Indian leadership, including the likes of Subhash Chandra Bose. And that is what the BJP is trying to do, not claim him as one of their own, Subhashini Ali.
Well, I would like to say that as far as the people of India are concerned, there is no national hero, I think, maybe with the exception of Bhagat Singh and Dr. Ambedkar, who commands the kind of love, affection, and spontaneous regard that Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose does in every corner of India. He is remembered every year. His birthday is commemorated and celebrated everywhere, whether it has got government support or doesn't have government support. The people in India have always revered him and always celebrated his birth and his life. And of course, governments have also paid whatever lip service or in an official way, his birthday has been celebrated always. It's not that something new is happening. In fact, I think that it is much more important when we remember Netaji to remember what he stood for, to remember what made him important. what made him different from many of the other leaders of his own party. And I think that what made him different was his tremendous commitment, his clarity of thought and his determination to stick to his principles. If we see what he did when he became the Congress president, what was one of the first steps he took? He changed the Congress constitution to say that no Congress member could be a member of a communal party like the Hindu Mahasabha or the Muslim League. And that was a time when many Congress leaders, important leaders like Rajendra Prasad and Madan Mohan Malviya, had this sort of dual membership. But why did Netaji insist on this amendment? It is because he was also convinced that it was only the unity of the Indian people that could bring about independence.
So let Chandra Bose respond to that. The point that Subhashini Ali makes is important, that